Yeah. everybody know your life is not your own. I'm glad to belong to the Lord, and that means you gotta take care of me. Is anybody glad about that today?
Thank you. Amen. Tabernacle, this time, let's get up and let's welcome our visitors and give them our attention. My name is Rochelle Thomas, and you're watching TVCS.
Please, no food or drinks in the sanctuary, and follow all cell phones. In an effort to create a distraction through worship experience, the overflow areas at Tab Main and Tab West will be available in a peak service to be utilized to attend to a child or nurse today. Our ambassadors will gladly assist you. Tabernacle Text Given allows you to give any time from anywhere with a single text. Text any amount to 774-482-2224 or 774-4-TAB-BCH. And Givelify, another way to give. Download the Tab Impact app, click on Give iOS or Give Android, set up, and you're on your way. Tabernacle Baptist Church now offers guest Wi-Fi at both campuses. To access, locate the TBC Guest Network and accept the terms and conditions in your connecting. Coming soon, the Women's Wellness Summit will be held on Saturday, July 29th from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. at the Family Life Center. Stay tuned for more information. Monday, July 10th through Wednesday, July 12th at 7 o'clock each night, Pastor Goodman will be a guest revivalist at the Sunshine Baptist Church annual summer revival in Blackville, South Carolina. Reverend Ethan Rowe is the pastor. On Thursday, July 13th at 7 o'clock p.m., Pastor Goodman will be the guest preacher for the Carpentersville Baptist Church Youth and Young Adult Summit in North Augusta, South Carolina. Reverend Herman Lee is the pastor. On Sunday, July 16th at 3:30 p.m., Pastor Goodman will be the guest preacher for the Pastoral Installation Service for Reverend Jason S. McSwain at St. Luke Baptist Church in Fairfax, South Carolina. Also, on Tuesday, July 18th through Thursday, July 20th, at 7 p.m. each night, Pastor Goodman will be the guest revivalist for the annual summer revival at Fairview Missionary Baptist Church on Village Hill Road. Reverend Chuck Smallwood is the pastor. The biannual church meeting will be held on Thursday, July 13th at 6:30 p.m. at the Tab West location. The agenda will include a review of the first half of the year's ministry and operations and a preview of the remaining 2017 ministry, event calendar, and operational goals. All members are encouraged to attend. As a courtesy to our members, this is notification that the Walls Group event previously scheduled for July 14th has been canceled. On behalf of the Walls Group management team, the website address on the screen is being provided for those with proof of purchase to receive a full refund. Please direct all communication regarding this event to the Walls Management Group. Our annual back-to-school blast will be held on Saturday, August 5th, from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. at both campuses. In preparation for the event, the church is asking for donations of school supplies. Supplies may be dropped off on Sundays at guest services or at the church office during the week. PG Summer Reading Challenge Program is now until August 6th. Forms will be picked up at the church office and on the room. Prizes will be given out at Camden Midday on August 19th. Tagnalia will be on sale after each service at both locations. There's a limited supply of chairs, shirts, keychains, and more. Purchase downstairs at Main and at guest services at West. For all ministry announcements and opportunities to serve, visit our website at tbcaugusta.org. And don't forget to check out the Tab Impact app. That was your TBC News. Thank you for fellowshipping with us at the most impactful place on the planet, Tabernacle Baptist Church.
As believers in Jesus Christ, we all need our faith to be strengthened. It is God's desire that we remain encouraged as we walk by faith. John 20, 30, 31 states, "And truly Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that believing you may have life in his name." Join us at the Tabernacle Main at 7:15 a.m., 9:45 a.m., and 11:45 a.m., and Tabernacle West at 9 a.m. Join Dr. Charles Goodman this summer during Sunday morning worship at both campuses as he encourages us to just believe.
Come on, let's give God some praises in the name of the Lord. Have you heard us rejoice? Oh, let me try it one more time. This is the name of the Lord. Has you heard us rejoice? And be glad again. Are you excited to be in the house of the Lord on today? Hallelujah. Amen. may be seated in the presence of God once again. The already has been on the July, and just a reminder, this is our family worship month. What we're trying to do with this month is thank God for those that serve. Most people don't realize that I say this, I have to remind both locations. We have what most people have in the church, we have in our youth church. And so both our locations, 945, 145 in Maine, at 9 o'clock here. Also team, and I'm grateful for those that sacrifice and serve us. I'm trying to at least choose one month out of here to do family worship. Can we thank God for our youth workers and those that serve? And, I want to thank them so much because it can be difficult. Amen. You know your kids. Amen. Touch me until you talk about your kids. I'm the perfect angels, amen. But we are so grateful and so appreciative of those who come and share. So thank you for those who sacrifice with us. And so it's our family worship. I'm to be mindful of all that we have. And then also this Thursday, I'll get you here. 6:30, we're going to have our biannual church meeting, amen. But we call it our vision. I have our sharing. So one of the things that we're doing it at West, we always do our biannual at West, and we do our end of year and name. But I got some incredible news that I need you to come specifically for Tabernacle West, as we are looking forward to the future. God has blessed us. I'm just excited to be able to share some information this week and going forward. And I want you to be a part of that. I won't keep you long. I don't believe in long meetings. I want you to come and get some great information and hear some things about your church and some things that you can help us to continue to try to do our best to give God glory and honor. Amen. Also, sabbatical months, we're trying to rest. So we ask that you just be mindful of that as we go forward so that we can honor God with rest. Rest is spiritual. Amen. Rest is spiritual. So we're trying our best. Because the rest of the year is going to be like this, man. We've had an incredible time, but we know how the year goes. And for us, especially what God has put on our plate. And so one of the things I always tell people, you don't ask God to bless you if you want to be comfortable and convenient. Amen. God's blessings oftentimes come with burdens, right? So you've got to be able to manage those. And so we're trying to take the time we can as a church, as a leadership, those that help us serve, to try to make sure that what God has called us to do. Amen. Let's stand to our feet. It's giving time to the house. It's our time to show God how much we love God and let us know potential ways. And so I'm grateful for an incredible congregation of people that just believe in being good stewards. I mean, we are stewards. We are stewards. Which simply means, God, you are the owner. We don't own it. We're just grateful that you bless us with it. And so I'm grateful for those that continue to share and give of their sustenance and trust us as a church to continue to do kingdom impacting work. That's why I want you to come, because a lot of times in our church meetings, you can see where our funds go, what we've been doing with the funds, and things that perhaps you don't even see or know. We want to make sure that you're in the know so that you can help us continue to stay committed to the kingdom. Let's recite Titus 3 coming together. God, I will bless your kingdom. Your division in this church. I will give you nothing from my pocket that did not come from my heart. I will not withhold the time that from the balance of units. One of the blessings open in my life. I desire to be faithful, productive, and fruitful, and committed to advancing God's kingdom on earth. Amen. If those gifts come, let's bless them. God, we thank you. We sow these seeds by faith, trusting in you, God, you've been good to us. We honor you and bless you in the precious name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Come on, divine glory, follow the direction of our guest services, our officers, serve those in the balcony of our worship team, sets gathers for forgiving and preaching at this time. good place to honor the other. That you learn people's your souls. And sometimes we get in a visual church. We act like we did it ourselves. But all of us have a pivotal moment and period where we realize he's our source. John tells us in John chapter 20, 30 to 31, he said, I could have wrote a whole lot of different